Revelio.
You haven't a clue why there's such a fuss over poaching.
Revelio. Revelio.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
May I have a moment of your time?
Pardon? Were you calling to me?
I was. I'm Marianne Moffat. Pleasure. At the moment, I'm having a great deal of trouble trying to find a particular diracle.
Ah, yes, the magical bird. Can disappear when it senses danger.
Peculiar things, aren't they? Did you know that muggles call them dodos? Such a funny name. I'm worried about a large albino diracle known as Guineira. She's a local legend, so of course poachers are after her. If I had her, I'd treat her like a queen. And I could use her molted feathers as fashion accessories.
Sounds as if she needs rescuing. I know the perfect place.
The perfect place is with me. Wait until the neighbours see her. Not to mention how fashionable I'll be with those beautiful feathers. I can't seem to rescue her, and I'm worried the Diracles don't trust me since I've been hanging about their den.
I'll keep an eye out for a large white Diracle.
Oh, thank you. Those gorgeous feathers. And she'd be safe. One last thing. She seems to spend her days in hiding. I've only ever seen her at night. I do hope you're able to save her. Be prepared to chase her. I sometimes wonder if she actually enjoys
Rebellion. The pursuit.
I suppose I should watch for Gwenyra. At night, apparently.
Revelio.
What do we have here? A demigod.
Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Revelio. Hello. Do you have anything for sale?
That I do. The name is Rohan Prakash, and welcome to the oldest shop in the region.
Is that right? How long have you been in business?
Well, I've only been running it a short time myself, but my father ran it for many years before he fell ill.
Oh, that's a shame. I'm sorry about your father.
Oh, he's still around. Would love to be doing what I'm doing. Until he is able, however. I will gladly manage it for the both of us. But for now, a word about your health and safety. I assume you're as concerned as the rest of us about the Goblin Uprising, the Dark Wizards, even the Dugbogs have gone mad. But our shop can sell you any number of supplies that will help to keep you safe from all of that. Please have a look, and do come back. You're always welcome here.
Thank you, Mr. Prakash. Best of luck to you and your father.
I appreciate your words.
What do you have for sale?
an excellent purchase. Thank you kindly for your business. Thank you. I hope to see you again.
This must be the Dirigul den that Miss Moffat told me about. Now where is Gwenyra? Grace. Got her. Now I need to let Miss Moffat know.
Revelio.
Any luck finding Gwenyra?
Miss Moffat, I caught Gwenyra.
That's incredible! Was it terribly difficult?
She was difficult to track down, but I managed in the end.
Believe me, I know. Well, may I have her now?
Actually, I think she'll be safer with me.
It was my idea to rescue her. I'm the one who fell in love with her beautiful plumage. Oh, the cheek. Now what shall I do? Without her feathers, I can't finish any of my fashion designs. You traitorous foul napper. I hope she picks your eyes out.
Lumos. Settle yourself. I mean you no harm.
Thank you.
Everything's all right now.
Professor Howell will never believe this.
I should let Deke know about the newborn Thestral. Settle yourself. I mean you no harm.
Thank you.
Accio. Wingardium Leviosa. Accio. Hello, Deke. You'll be pleased to know that a little Thestral was born.
How wonderful to have more Thestrals in our world. Such misunderstood beasts.
I'm sorry that we can both see Thestrals, Deke.
Deke is privileged to see such majestic beasts, but sometimes wishes Deke couldn't. Deke is to blame.
What do you mean, to blame?
Years ago, Deke's master ordered Deke to help him capture a phoenix, the rarest of all beasts that Master had spotted high on a cliff. The phoenix was the most beautiful beast Deke had ever seen. Deke begged Master to leave her be. When Deke hesitated to climb up the cliff as ordered, Deke had to punish himself. As Deke punished himself, Master grew angrier and angrier, and in his frustration cast at the regal bird. Deke suspects the phoenix was protecting eggs when it swooped down in fear and fury. Before Deke could reach him, Master fell from the cliff. Deke stayed on that cliffside for days, punishing himself, before Tobbs found him.
It sounds to me as if your master got what he deserved.
Deke never wanted anyone to get hurt. Not the phoenix, not Tobbs, and not even Master. Deke often wonders what became of that phoenix. Deke feels fortunate to be at Hogwarts now, helping you rescue beasts. Perhaps Deke can make amends for what came before.